There is no criminal more frightening than the serial killer. From Ted Bundy to the Unabomber, they instill fear and generate morbid public fascination. Their horrific crimes have spawned saturation media coverage, movies, and now websites devoted to every aspect of every crime.
We're talking about murder.
Lawyer and San Francisco State professor Miriam Smith has examined many of the websites devoted to serial killers. She teaches classes on ethics and responsibilities in electronic media.
So the thought is, we post all this information and maybe it will jog someone's memory and they'll come forward with some pertinent piece of information that is as yet unknown to the police and will assist the police in solving the crime.
I felt like this is solvable. This case is, you know, really solvable.
So Tom Voigt, a Portland, Oregon website designer, set out to solve perhaps the most infamous unsolved serial murder case in American history. The Zodiac Killer, who haunted the San Francisco area in the 1960s and 70s, killed five and took credit for dozens more. No badge, no gun, Voigt's only crime-solving tool, a URL, ZodiacKiller.com.
And I thought, well, this is 30 or 25 years old, and there's nothing new in the case. It doesn't make any sense. And at that point, I realized I was going to start a website. I just felt from the beginning that that would be the way to collect the information and to make it available for everyone.
ZodiacKiller.com is a cyber case file with sections devoted to victims like David Faraday and Betty Lou Jensen, Voigt's primary murder suspect, Arthur Lee Allen, and evidence. From the taunting letters the Zodiac sent to local newspapers to the original police reports, everything is available online. Interactivity is the key. There are message boards for people to post and debate ideas about the case, and forums for people to submit information about new suspects.
I've got surviving victims' email, but also the surviving family and friends too. All of them are supportive. They're all really happy with, and they've contributed lots of stuff. I think I've emailed everybody significant in the case. I get a lot of email from investigators and from current and past investigators.
Like this one from Ed Rust, a retired officer who worked the Zodiac case from the beginning. He disagrees with Voigt's theory that Allen was the Zodiac killer.
Incident by incident, timeline, date, who was the victim, what matches up with each case, which doesn't match up with each case. And Tom, again, has done that very well.
Another site user, Lieutenant Brian Banducci, who has recently been assigned the Zodiac case by the Napa County Sheriff's Department.
It's an open case for most people. Is it worked actively? No.
But with a site like ZodiacKiller.com, the case can be worked on at any time by anyone. In a yellow cab parked right here at this corner in San Francisco, investigators found the last confirmed victim of the Zodiac Killer, cab driver Paul Stein. What did investigators find, and how does that fit into the big puzzle? Well, that's up to you. The full picture of the crime scene is online.
And it's evidence like this, now accessible to the public as well as the police, that Voigt hopes will pressure the police to do more to bring the case to a resolution.
If some amateur guy could put the site together and generate leads and make advances in the case, what the hell are the police doing?
The police are still investigating, and although they haven't charged anyone, Voigt does.
I think it was that guy, Arthur Lee Allen.
And in fact, Arthur Lee Allen was a suspect to police, but never formally charged. A mistake, according to ZodiacKiller.com. From his Zodiac watch with the same circle cross symbol the killer used in his letters, to Allen's proximity to the crime scenes, the heart of ZodiacKiller.com is the case laid out against Allen. Police reports, a murder-by-murder timeline, interviews with people to whom Allen allegedly confessed. The site has even generated evidence like this cryptogram from a Zodiac letter, which when rearranged forms Allen's middle name, Lee.
I'm not the Zodiac killer.
That was Arthur Lee Allen before he died in 1992, denying any involvement in the Zodiac case. And given his denials and the lack of formal charges, are there legal concerns about a website making these kinds of accusations?
You look at these websites and they make these assertions or allegations. They try and match up all these different dates or match up these different people and someone's recollection. And a lot of this wouldn't stand up in court, and you have to read these things knowing that, you know, this is evidence that's been sort of untried or untested or uncontested.
Meanwhile, the online gumshoes who use the ZodiacKiller.com website remain relentless in their search for the killer.
And they can't get enough new information. I have to update my site every week, otherwise people email me and complain. I mean, there was 30 years where nothing happened. And now if I don't update my website with new info every week, then people get to, like, start jonesing.